Okay, you cannot discuss joints without talking about the main clinical importance associated with joints, and that's arthritis. We've all heard of arthritis. We'll talk about the three main types in this video. Now, when you're saying arthritis, it's really a catch-all term. It's any type of inflammation of a joint. Now, depending on specifically what's inflamed, how it goes about being inflamed is the interchange in terms of the different types of arthritis. So we'll talk about the most common one first, which is osteoarthritis. This is the wear and tear version of arthritis. Typically, you have this specific type of arthritis in older individuals. It's an example of a degenerative joint disease. And what's occurring with arthritis is this cartilage, remember your articular cartilage, which is on the end of the bones, this is actually going to be gradually lost. So you have the actual loss of the cartilage, allowing for bone-on-bone contact. Now, anytime you have bone-on-bone contact, that leads to a lot of other things. It can lead to additional erosion of the cartilage around it. Anytime that you have friction between the bones, that will get those osteoblasts moving faster, allowing for bony spurs in the region, which is what you can see here. You can see that your osteoblasts are kind of going into overdrive, and you have these really painful bony spurs that can occur here. Now, you find these in larger or higher frequencies in older individuals, but in individuals that are frequent runners or athletes, you can have more of a wear and tear in those individuals. So you see this particular type of arthritis earlier on in individuals that are strong in terms of athletics. Now, you've probably heard the term gout before, and you probably didn't realize that this is actually a type of arthritis. So this is very similar to osteoarthritis, except in terms of how it's actually formed. And what can happen is that you're going to have this crystallization of uric acid. So basically, individuals that have a diet that is very high in purines will allow for uric acid to kind of build up, particularly in joints that are more distal of the body. And this can allow for erosion of not only the cartilage, that articular cartilage, but of the joint capsule itself. So this can actually be quite severe. Now, we'll come back to the purines in just a second, but I wanted to point out the reason that this visual is showing this metatarsophalangeal joint right here is because this is the most common area in terms of where you're going to have the presentation of gouty arthritis. Now, let's think about diets that are high in purines. What would you have to consume in order to have a diet high in purines? So things like processed meats, alcohol is a big one. You can have some type of particularly processed seafood, so to be even more specific there. So individuals that have diets high in terms of deli meats, alcohol, will be more likely to have gouty arthritis. And that's exactly what happens. You can see you have a complete breakdown in terms of the cartilage here and a buildup of the uric acid in that region. So it can be a pretty bad presentation. You have the inflammation of that entire area. Now, the last type of arthritis we're going to discuss is rheumatoid arthritis, and this is actually an example of an autoimmune disease. So your body is actually kind of sending signals that the cartilage in the region of particular joints, there's kind of fighting that cartilage and kind of tearing it apart. So the body's kind of fighting itself, as in most autoimmune diseases. Now, rheumatoid arthritis is one of the main examples where you see this in younger individuals as well as older individuals. So most arthritis cases are in older individuals. You can find this in younger individuals. And a lot of times where you see the presentation of rheumatoid arthritis are in the joints associated with the digits of the hand. And you can have this almost claw-like appearance because you have the breakdown of specific components of that joint capsule. So you have that claw-like appearance in terms of rheumatoid arthritis. Now, you can have it in other joints of the body. This is just where you typically have the more common presentation of this. So those are the three main types of arthritis. Recall and review that any type of inflammation of a joint is considered arthritis. It's just dependent on the particular presentation, at what joints, and what's causing the particular arthritis that differs.